Here's a case, 82-year-old male, insulin-dependent diabetic. He had had a fifth amputation at another hospital center. He had initially had a trauma to the fifth toe while walking barefoot. He actually stubbed it on a piece of furniture at his home. Who hasn't done that, right? Unfortunately, because of his diabetes, he had had a cut in the skin that became infected. He had some poor blood flow to the area. The fifth toe became gangrenous and then ended up having an amputation. Well, you can see, unfortunately, prior to the amputation, the treating clinician did not assess the blood flow or optimize blood flow. So the area continued to deteriorate. You see some gangrene present, some necrosis. We see that fourth toe is real dusky, doesn't look good. We have a non-healing ulcer where the amputation plate was placed. So he came into our clinic because at that neighboring facility, he was only given the opportunity for a below knee amputation. Now he was 82, but he was a fry 82. He has grandkids and he's a golfer. So he was not happy with the only option being a below knee amputation. So we did some non-invasive vascular studies. We did an ABI, an ankle brachial index, and we found that it was 0.6. So he was on the edge of critical limb ischemia. And we decided to go ahead and send him to our vascular surgeon for a workup to see if we can salvage his foot. So remember that patient that had that fifth toe amputation and the gangrenous changes and a lot of devitalized tissue with that 0.6 ABI. So we sent him to vascular. He was revascularized to optimize the blood flow. And then I went ahead and took him to surgery. I did a transmetatarsal amputation and he went on to healing incident. He was transitioned to diabetic foot or diabetic shoes with a toe filler. And I think it's really important, you know, once you get a patient to heal, a patient that has diabetes that's uncontrolled, has neuropathy, has previous, you know, gangrene or infection or ulceration, and you finally get them healed, now you have to ask yourself, now what? Because these wounds tend to be highly they come back. The recidivism rate for patients is really great. So you have to work with your podorthist or your prosthetic specialist in your area or your hospital to get these patients into a well-fitted shoe with a toe filler if needed to prevent any kind of tissue breakdown or further tissue breakdown from developing. And again, education with these patients is really important. So don't transition a patient like this after surgery and after healing an ulcer just back into regular shoes, because I'll guarantee you they'll continue to break down. They'll be in your office in the next couple months. And, you know, everybody's so excited when we heal an ulcer, but when the patient has come back, you know, we kind of become deflated.